Toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Porter is lined up to kick this one off, and you can feel the thunder in the crowd as they await the start of this game. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Longhorns and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. When you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
And they lose a couple there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Makes it to the 31. A gain of 8 on the carry. Back's got it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 37.
Some nice touch on that throw. A screen can be tricky to execute because you're actually allowing the defense to come right at you as a quarterback. And that's what you want. One missed block, and it could easily result in lost yardage.
And he's taken down around the 47-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
From the 47-yard line, first down. He scrambles. They bring him down. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
So that sack sets them back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. He's taken down around the 48-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it 3rd and 11.
He heaves it deep. Incomplete. Almost picked off.
It's always big when you can get in the way of a pass on third down because you know the offense is bringing it.
Rust awaits the snap. Booming kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. The 33-yard line.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 29.
Really good play here in run support by the linebacker. The big guys up front took away the running lanes, and he was able to get through for a loss.
Throw to the tight end. They'll bring him down around the 35-yard line. From their own 35-yard line, third down.
Mike four.
Was he drilled as he let go of that football?
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
That makes it fourth and eight. Washington is back awaiting the punt. And this one is a beauty. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Has some daylight. Nice run to the left there.
The quarterback held on to it and turned it into a first down. That's very frustrating for this defense.
The middle for a nice game.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
From their own 40-yard line, it's second down. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 47. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That brings him second and five.
To the tailback, and he's hit immediately for a loss. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 43. Wants to throw outside. It's complete. Tackle at the 15. We've played one quarter. Still no score. Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point. It's the tailback. Nice run there as they work the outside. This is the 10th play of this drive.
That makes it second and two.
He's tackled around the 9-yard line. So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. Here's the halfback on the screen, and it pays off. Touchdown. They decided to go to the running back on that touchdown pass.
Just a nice job by the quarterback of showing great patience here, going through his progressions, finally finding the back to get into the end zone.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was an 11-play, 81-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle made at the 25-yard line. He's going to pick up less than a yard on the quarterback scramble.
There's the junior cornerback making a very solid stop. Anytime your corners can contribute like that against the run, it gives your defense another advantage.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. And they make the stop around the 44-yard line. From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. And he's going to come up with a sack. And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on third down. Gets it out to him again.
Well, it was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
Morton back deep to return. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Gives it to the back.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that ball.
From their own 16-yard line, second down. He's out to the 30, and he's tackled at the 31. Here. He's going to scramble. He's to the 40. He dives and he'll be marked down. Well, they didn't get the first down, but it was still a pretty good run by the quarterback.
He made a good decision to take off there.
About 2 minutes before halftime.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Pulls it in and gets out of bounds.
That's a deep bomb, right? First down.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. Gets it. He's in space. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
Number 15 makes the sets call.
And he's taken down at the 39-yard line. From the 39-yard line, first down. scrambling around. Decides to slide. Newberry gains about 2 yards on the scramble. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Knocked out of bounds at the 33. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Runs outside for a nice game. The Longhorns are going to call their second timeout. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. To his receiver, and he hits him hard at the 17. You know, this is just amazing. You spend 6 days planning as a defensive coordinator for one guy, and then you get the other quarterback. So now what happens?
And he is drilled at the 4-yard line.
That makes it first and goal. He's taken down at the 2. They'll get 2 on that one.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
Brought down at the 1. He's scrambling. Shows some moves, and he's in.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for, an opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
And he adds the extra point. We've played a half of football. The Longhorns lead 14-0.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
Maybe the most important statistic from the first half, no turnovers for either team. So far, a good job of ball security, but now you wonder if the quarterbacks can avoid putting the ball in jeopardy. They're going to want to make a big play, and that might sort of set off a feeding frenzy on the defensive side.
Yeah, and it's in defenses, that's the number one priority. I mean, you can give up a lot of yards. They can chew up yards up and down the field, but if you can force turnovers, then you're keeping them off the scoreboard, and that's your number one goal. So defenses, they have to be a little bit upset right now, and they got to try to find ways to hit harder. How about when you're tackling? Use the be able to strip the ball out, get the ball out, try to get some interceptions, try to make some user picks, do whatever you can to try to get the football back from that offense and set your offense up in good field position.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Richardson takes it at the 4. The Longhorns continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. From their own 22-yard line, it's second down. And he's hit immediately. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Tillman, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. Second and nine. Ball on their own 34. Caught. Open field. He's brought down in the open field. Great tackle at the 47.
That makes it second and six.
From the 47-yard line, second down. Caught with room to work. Good tackle there in space.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll bring them third and inches.
Man left, man left. Four down.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. And brought down. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds and those receivers might have been open.
They come up to the line here at second down and 14 after the sack.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Tenth play of the drive. Picks up another first down.
Well, this really works on a defensive psyche. You can see the guys on defense right now just trying to catch their wind. Once again, they had a chance to bring this drive to a halt, but were unable to do it. The offense really seems to be clicking right now.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 25-yard line. And he's tackled right away. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Boy, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
Play 13 of the current drive.
Well, that's another first down, Brad. That's the fifth first down on this drive. You know, this offense isn't hitting a lot of big plays, but they're very, very consistent with their execution. It's putting a lot of pressure right now on this defense.
And they got it.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, or especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. They give to the tailback. Gets to about the 17-yard line. And this is the 16th play of the drive. This one should be makeable. He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. Porter has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. We're about set to start things up again. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
I tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. The Longhorns in front by 11. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. And he has it on the corner. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 27-yard line. So they pick up big yards on the option keeper.
I thought he was going to break that one for a touchdown. You couldn't draw that up any better.
From the 27-yard line, it's first down. He makes his way to about the 18.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That makes it second and two.
He scrambled. Tackle at the 9-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Little screen pass intercepted. He scores. What a play. So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a 2-point conversion.
Here we go. Black Lightning. Black Lightning.
Passes it to the middle of the field. One. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's going to be interesting now to see if this quarterback can put that last throw behind him.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes.
Throws to the receiver, incomplete.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
Washington on the give. He takes it right side for a good gain.
That's a gain of seven on the play. That makes it third and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Play fake. Going deep. And he stays in bounds and he hauls in a big one. So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. Made to the 27-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Less than 3 minutes in the game. To the halfback on the screen. And down he goes at the 24-yard line. Thomas picks him up about 3 yards with the catch.
Nice throw and catch there to get past the sticks.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. Just throws this one away. His way out to about the 12.
I think the defense put everything into that sequence of plays, and for the offense to come up with a first down really is demoralizing for the defense.
The offense looking here to exercise any red zone. And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown. Well, that touchdown should just about ice this one. Point. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. He chucks it downfield. Oh, what an interception. That pick will end this game. From their own 37-yard line, first down. He's tackled around the 40-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Thomas gains about 4 yards on the play.
Third down.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock.
Blue 14.
He'll go down to one knee.
Two down. Mike two.
Fleming's performance today, I think nationally, Kirk, is going to take a hit as him being a superstar. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it could hurt him, but at the same time, the team won. He didn't have a great game, but the fact that his team was able to kind of rally and still come up with a win, I still think it helped his cause as far as some of the national recognition.
For EA Sports, Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.